When your editor goes home to Dublin in Ireland, he travels all the time by bus and finds himself reflecting on what he sees there and the people he is traveling with. And here is a beautiful reflection by Elaine Aquino, who wrote it when she was still only 15. Similar to my own experiences riding on a jeepney in Cagayan de Oro and reflecting on the lives of the people she was traveling with.
Every day, I try to find myself and I try to find the meaning behind the things I see and the things that happen to me. Why? Because like most of us, there is a struggle within me that never ceases. I am discontented, a word that can easily define us humans in the natural sense. As I observe the people around me when I go to and from school on a jeepney, I wonder if they also make an effort at finding themselves or the meaning of things. On a daily basis, they work for a living. And during their day-to-day routine of pushing carts, selling barbecues, begging money, driving jeepneys, or even doing almost nothing the whole day, I wonder if at the end of the day, they still try to figure out why these things happen to them. When I ride the jeepney, tired yet still surprisingly energized from the activities in school, I often look at some of the passengers and wonder how it would be like to live in their shoes. It would probably be a whole new kind of life story, different from mine. We probably lead different, unique lives. Even if coincidence has it that some of us may have certain similarities pertaining to the events of our lives to others we may or may not know, I still believe our lives are unique. I strongly believe such because we are created one by one, each with his or her own mind, body, and soul. And thus, we think and feel differently. But when I say we're unique, it doesn't mean we don't need each other. Although I am a loner and a very private person, I can say that people still need other people, not because we are dependent, but because God gave them to us to accompany us, to befriend us, to love us as He did. And although we can't love other people as God loved us and will still love us, I believe we can at least share it in our own way to everyone as a sign of appreciation for what God has given us. Isn't that very smart of Him? That, even if He gave us unique minds, souls, and bodies, He still gave us other people to share our lives with. I guess that's how God loves us and much more. Maybe He doesn't want us to be lonely. Next time, when we get tired at the end of a day's work, maybe we can spend a little time to thank God for whatever He gave us, for what He will still give us, and especially for the people He created as instruments of His love.